I tell people I was raised by a community, and a lot of graceful, outstanding women who guided and nurtured me from an early age in terms of how they dress.
Something I think I learned from watching women like Michelle Obama, they use fashion to make a statement. It's not just about what you wear.
I am a woman, a single woman, a professional woman. That's what you see. What you see is what you get.
I'm proud, you know, I am. I'm proud that I have an opportunity to be a part of a legacy that is so much bigger than me.
Using the space that you have and the influence that you have to make life better for other people who may not have it. God, I think that's really important.
There's so many women out here with something to say, with a story to tell.
Well, I think the thing that is so important, at least for where we are, particularly in St. Vincent and the wider Caribbean right now, is courage. So it's being able to talk about what your personal experiences have been, and that then gives other people the space to tell those stories. I think that's really how we create inclusive spaces.
Nothing wrong with being brave. As a matter of fact, that could well be your superpower.
I do think that I pushed a lot of boundaries during my pageant time, and I believe that fashion, I use fashion as one of my means of communicating.
I have a lot of moments, but some that stood out with Poshelle and Jeremy Payne. Those were two major moments. We had She Caribbean was at that event, and to see their growth and how they've become international, you know, they're outfitting international person, those were my really big moments.
You have to earn the respect of your peers in the business world. You know, you put in the work, put in the hours, the months, the years, and you earn the respect.
Feminism that actually pertains to your life and using those people as allies as well, that's really important too, in order to really create full spaces that really embrace everybody.
I like who I am. I love who I am, and I enhance what is given to me.
Beauty is not just, it's more than physical. The essence of a person makes them beautiful.
Society coming around to women being different and coming in all different shapes and sizes is also of the utmost importance.
I always encourage that we showcase all sizes, because persons of all sizes wear clothes, and that's what we really have to show people, how they can look in clothing.
Say feminism is a global project, it is a project that includes men. So if they could see themselves as part of that project, then we'd have the spaces that we want.
As a woman, I wanted to make sure that although I am creative and I can execute well and I can do all these great things, that I also received the necessary education, the paper, the piece of paper that's necessary to tell others that I can do it. I think that's one of the distinctions between a male and a female. The man can say he can do it and everybody would believe. But for us, sometimes we have to make sure we have that extra piece of paper that tells the world that we are certified to do what we're doing.
Connotation is that to be girly is to be weak, or, you know, that I'm tomboyish.
I don't think you can truly have women's empowerment if you're not including everybody. If you're not thinking about people who experience their womanhood in different ways, who experience femininity in different ways, then you're necessarily putting limits on how far we can go.
I faced colorism in my own country. That would have to change. That would take a society coming together and deciding that these are the things we need to change. There's texturism. These are the things that I would like to change.
To thine own self be true.
It is important for us as women in St. Vincent and the Grenadines to be able to take care of ourselves. And I think once you ask for help, a lot of the times we don't ask for help. But if we ask for help, I think there are a lot of females who would be willing to provide the necessary guidance for other women to be able to empower themselves.
What is required of you as one, a parliamentary representative, to listen to the people, empathize with them, serve them, be with them, mourn with them, laugh with them, rejoice with them. You know, I used to, as a 12-year-old kid, and everybody getting breasts, and I wasn't getting any breasts. And I asked my mom, why am I not getting any breasts? She said, well, you wait, you will get. She said, I wish I could have breasts like that. I had a cousin that had a full load, like 54. And I said, I want big, big breasts. And I prayed for big breasts. And I got what I prayed
for. Using your relative privilege.
I encourage young women through my social media platform all the time. I make sure to voice my opinions when it comes to colorism, especially in the Caribbean.
I always consider myself to be beautiful. I consider I had a flat forehead, which was, they say, the mind of my Kalinawa ancestry, and high cheekbones. I have moles which come from another part of a different civilization on my cheeks.
I truly believe that beauty is in the eye of the beholder, and once I'm satisfied with who I see in the mirror and who I am on the inside, what society forms as a beauty norm is, doesn't really matter to me.
I have thick, well-developed, luscious lips, which are indicative of my femininity and my sexuality. And I consider myself beautiful.
And that these days, the people that I'm looking to for inspiration are generally people who are younger than me, personally enough. Because I think that when I look at my young clients, especially young queer clients, less constrained than I would have been at their same age. So as much as it's, I would hope to be a role model to them, they're actually kind of a role model for me, and kind of like as an example of how to be free in your own identity.
Hold on to yourself and understand yourself and love yourself. You don't need to fit somebody else's idea of what beauty is to understand that the beauty is within you.
We are known for producing strong women who make significant contributions to our society.
I'm fortunate, I've always said that. I had a mother who was in the public service for over 30 years, retired at the top of the ranks.
One of a kind, classic.
The women in my life, my mother, my sister, my grandmother, my aunts, have always been very strong women who have known themselves and who have exuded power while being gentle, while being loving.
One of the things I want to be remembered for is helping others, especially women.
Advocating for people who you think may need to be platformed and maybe aren't in the position to be as vocal as maybe I am being. So
this position offers me the opportunity to chart the way forward for the next generation of leaders. So it's exciting.
You can't be afraid to run hard or face the cricket ball or slide in for the football tackle.
Sister one is like, everybody was like, and will your sister go in for the queen to be a kind of a queen? And I was like, no.
There are people out there who feel similar to you, who are going to be accepting of you. Yeah.
When you're comfortable in your own skin, as a woman, it could be very intimidating. And, you know, for those who feel intimidated, they need to work on that. Because it's never my intention, but I will not, never be true to myself. I will always be true to myself. And that is the encouragement I give to everyone. Be true to yourself, know yourself, and be comfortable in your own skin.